Hello children, welcome to your maths class. Children, today we are going to do a new topic and the name of the topic is borrowing sums. So we are going to learn about borrowing sums in subtraction. If you remember children, previously we had solved subtraction sums. The sums used to be like this, 37 minus 25. So in these type of questions, it was very simple to solve because you put the finger at the smaller number, that is at the bottom, and count till the bigger number, 5, 6, 7, 2. And 2, 3, that would be 12 would be your answer. But today we are not going to do these type of questions. We are going to solve different type of questions today. So let us see what kind of questions are there. So now, first of all, let me see. We will first solve the right side of the question. Now, the catch over here is you have a smaller number at the top and bigger number at the bottom because 7 is a bigger number and 4 is a smaller number. But when we see the number at totality, 44 is a bigger number compared to 27. Remember this thing, children, in subtraction sums, the bigger number will be at the top and the smaller number will be at the bottom. 93, see, it is a bigger number compared to 88, so it will be at the top. 42 is a bigger number compared to 15. So the bigger number will be at the top and the smaller number will be at the bottom. Now let us see how we will solve this type of question. Now 7 is a bigger number and it is at the bottom. Now what to do? Now we will cut the number over here and which number comes before 4, we will write. Before 4 comes 3. So you will write 3 over here and you will write 1 over here. So what does this 1 means? Now your 4 is converted into 14. Now this 4 is changed into 14. When we are borrowing, we always take 1. We will take this number from here. So this is the number that we are taking. We will cut 4 and we will write the number that comes before. Okay. So the number that comes before 4 is 3. So we will write 3 over here and we will take and we will write 1 over here. So over here the number that 4 will be converted into will be 14. Now we will count from 7 till 14. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. How many? 7. So over here we will write 7. Okay, so over here we will write 7. So this is how these sums will be solved. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. How much? 7. So over here we will write 7. Now we will put the finger at 2 and count till the bigger number. So 2 and 3. So your answer will be 17. So your answer will be 17 over here. So this is how you are going to solve these questions. Now let us solve the second one. How to go about the second question, children? See, first again we will look at this part of the question. So again the same problem is coming. Over here is the smaller number and over here it is the bigger number. So we will cut 9 and we will write which number comes before 9? Before 9 comes 8. So you will write 8 over here and you will put 1 over here. So this one basically represents 13. So again we have a bigger number now. 13 is a bigger number compared to 8. Now we will start our counting from 8 till 13. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. How many fingers? 5 fingers. So 5 will be written over here. And then children, you will solve the left hand side. Now over here, as it is written 8 and 8, so you will put 0 over here. So 8 minus 8 will be 0. So now let us solve another question. So here is another question for you. We will again look at the right hand side part. So the right hand side over here, again you will see that 2 is a smaller number and 5 is a bigger number. So we will cut 4 and write 3 over here. And we will put 1 over here. So this one is 12. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 7 over here. And 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So 2 over here. So answer will be 27. So over here the answer will be 27. Now let's solve 56 minus 37. Again, children, we are going to look at this part of the question. So now we will again carry. We will write 4 over here and 1 over here. So here the number will be 16. And from 7 we will count till 16. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So it will be 9. So over here we will write 9. And 4, 2, 3 and 4 it will be 19. So your answer should come 19. Okay. So now again I'm going to solve one more question so that the topic is clear to you all. So if I write 48 minus 29. So how will I do? Again here it is a smaller number, here it is a bigger number if we see this part of the question. So we will write 3 over here and 1 over here. So this one will represent 18 and we will move from 9 till 18. 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So again 9 fingers, so we will write 9 over here and 2 to 3 it will be 1. So your answer will be 19. Okay, I hope the concept is clear to you all children. Thank you, class.